You know, Opie, when you said to me, go a day without your phone, you may as well have said, Jim, go a day without sunshine.
Oh.
Or the laughter of a child or a smile of a stranger.
Impossible.
Jim, go a day without looking at your reflection in the lake.
My wife is like, wow, it's really nice to hang out with you the last couple of days. I'm constantly on that thing. Like, yeah, it's kind of neat, I guess. She's trying to, like,
Ooh, nice phone. I used to have that one.
She's trying to rid me of my habit. And I don't even realize she's seeing me do it. And all of a sudden I'll hear from across the room, don't do that. Stop doing that. What are you doing? Don't do that. Stop doing that.
There's three things this could be.
Uh-oh. So first of all, is it just you and her in the room?
Yeah.
Okay, so it's not the other guy thing.
All right. Not a couple.
I don't know.
Just Steve from Bayshore. She means breathing.
Steve. God.
It's going south quickly.
Yeah. Steve's a pisser.
That is funny. Stop doing that.
I told her, I go, I know what you're up to. You know, I mean, there's an age difference, obviously. I'm like, I get a little older, and you're going to have the run of the place. You're going to just abuse me constantly.
What is she trying? Is it Tiger Woods golf that she's screaming at you about?
Nah, she's cool when it comes to video games and all that. She's actually cool with how I'm on my phone a lot.
What is she screaming at you for?
It's either blasting ones in the room.
I already told her there's no way that's stopping because I can't help myself. I got a sour stomach.
All right, see, that's what I thought first.
I think I might be lactose intolerant. I think I got it figured out. I might have to go to the soy.
When you told the little story about how you had stunk the entire apartment up,
oh,
and
boy.
She walked in the house in
unexpectedly,
the room, and just, I'm like, oh my God. He gassed up the entire place.
And her really nice blanket she got for Christmas.
So I thought that
I think she threw out.
It. Then it's got to be digging.
Yeah.
All right.
So you know,
that was second place.
She has had it.
Has she had it?
She's had it.
Oh, Jesus.
She gave me some leeway. I can't keep my effing fingers out of my nose. And I think it's an allergy thing or something because it just is constantly dry.
She's got to get you a shock collar right. And just hit the button
right.
Like a dog.
But then I'm thinking I'm like getting away with it, and she's not even looking at me. Stop that.
She's
stop doing that. Don't do
vision.
That.
Sees the corner of your eye, sees the hand go up.
Yeah, I guess.
Wow.
But is there some kind of product where you could keep your nose moist or something so I could keep my fingers out of there?
The tissue.
Instead of going for the joke, I need some advice.
I'll tell you what I use, only because I've had dry sinuses since my surgery.
Look, right now I'm going like this, like I'm a coke addict or something.
What happened
I'm constantly
is, it's not even
nose.
About the inside of the nose, it's more the addiction. It's like smoking, in that it wasn't just the nicotine I was hooked on, it was the motion of the hand, it became this comfort thing.
Right.
So it's a lot of times, it's just, you have to, in any type of an addiction that is so 50 times a day, just don't do it. Just get used to a victory of, I didn't do it for a half hour. I didn't do it for an hour. It sounds corny.
Right.
But then all of a sudden you're like, oh my God, I was on the computer for 3 hours and I didn't do that. Just be aware of the hands to the face thing.
It's killing me.
But
right
there's
now.
Something to it, though. It's some, I don't know what psychological need it's for. It's just an addiction.
It's sound advice, Jimmy, but you need something a little more extreme. I say funnel. One of those doggy, put a big doggy funnel over your head.
Well, how about you go septic? But I would say just be really aware of it, and just be aware that when your hands are going to your face, just say that this is serving some kind of a need. What is it? It will Dude, eventually break.
But when I go with the blowing out of the nose, it's quite impressive every single morning.
But you know that
there's stuff going
oh,
on.
Oh, yeah.
Me too.
Constantly.
Me too. Every morning, you know, it's just like a friggin' mess.
I clear out the whole inner wall.
That's it.
But it's not about it
you
being
get a nice clearing out of the whole inner wall where you're like, wow, how is that in there?
I take the tissue and
I
kind of crumple it up and then make the old auger motion.
Yeah.
And, you know, once I'm clean in the morning, unless I have a cold, I'm good for the whole day.
How about this? It's not just about the nose because I have horrendous sinuses. It is simply an addiction. Like, it's like scratching your eye, or it's like anything like that where it's a hand-to-face thing. Something. It's like it's just a habit that has to be broken, and it's just like it's a Jones. It's an irrational Jones. Like, I got to do it. It's like, but why? There's nothing there. Get saline if you want to get those. get saline to bless up the nose.
I hear what you're saying, Jimmy, but there's always something there. Trust me.
It's mental. I'm
always something there.
90% of the time, it's probably mental.
It probably goes back to my dad having hankies.
Hanky. You never wanted to use the hanky.
Nope.
Your nose is running. Here, wipe it. And then your father would hand you like a hanky. My father had hankies, too. Like, I don't want... That's called a dried mucus rag.
When my dad died, it was a nice gesture. I think it was... I'm trying to remember which brother. But he wanted to hand out my dad's hankies to the boys. I'm like,
oh, no.
Look, I miss my dad horribly, but I don't need one of his hankies that he used.
People who chew their nails. Are their nails always long and they need to be chewed?
I used to be a nail chewer. I haven't chewed mine. I can't even tell you the last time.
But I'm saying that there's no rational reason why they do it. It just becomes this nervous habit of addiction.
Yeah, I can't even tell you.
Same thing with that. How did she tell you? Like, what did she say to you? Like
who?
Your wife. What did she say about that? She's just like, hey, look.
No, she just, like, she's had it. But her best friend does it, too. So her best friend eats all of them. I don't eat all of them.
Oh, Jesus.
You're crazy if you eat all of them. You got to choose which ones you're going to eat.
No, you got to not at all.
Why?
Yeah.
No.
You've never eaten a booger.
I can honestly
tell
you. I'm
not going to sit here and make believe that people aren't eating boogers out there.
I could honestly tell you with every bit of honesty that I would swear on any loved member of my family.
If we brought God in here, he'd go, well, God, there was that one time. You God probably didn't realize, but you did.
Never, ever. Did I?
How about you're 6 or 7 years old?
No. I've never eaten any snot product.
Let's play.
I can't fathom it. I am so grossed out by snot.
Tomorrow, let's play.
Yeah.
Would you eat that? It's a very simple game that I just popped into my head.
Off.
No, this is what we're going to do. Everyone blows their nose in the morning. I want the staff to blow their nose. I'm not going to eat your boogers, so don't get all grossed out there. But you show me what you got in your little tissue, and I will tell you if that was mine, if I would eat it or not.
Oh, my God.
Dude, we would put pictures up on the web, and you can play along at home. Because you really have to choose the ones you're going to eat.
I've eaten boogers. I mean, we all have. I mean, Ann hasn't. But it's not, for me, it's not.
Yeah.
It's not, for me, it's not a thing.
Yeah.
But you see, now I'm watching you do it. It's like, I know what it's like. Believe me, I'm Nick Nervous, and I'm Harry Habit. I can't stop. I blink left rapidly. But I'm the same way.
I don't want to hear Jimmy's therapy crap over the nose thing today.
You don't have to, but it's the truth.
No, it's not. It's just that my nose constantly has boogers in it, and I'm pulling them out.
Okay.
But I'm trying to blow out my nose. It's losing it. Jimmy's trying to get a deeper meaning, and I'm just trying to stop.
If you don't look at it for what it is, as a habit, it's like if you blast saline up your nose,
because
that will clear it a little bit and make it a little bit moist.
I did a little lotion, and that seems to help.
Yeah,
you know.
But it's the addiction of hand to face. I'm telling you, I don't know what the psychological reason is, but it is an addiction.
Mm.
Rather do A to mouth.
Oh, Jesus. No. Please. Or A to V. They hate that one. It's not much bacteria. Well, that sounds like a you problem.
Right. Shut up, septic.
All right. We got to get the hell out of here.
Heck.
So. The heck out of here, yeah.
Oh.
I will be discussing nose picking further with all my followers on Twitter. OP Radio on Twitter. Ant's got his Facebook that he kind of accepts new friends from time to time.
Oh, I've been pretty good with it.
What's your name for the peeps out there?
Anthony Cumia. Cumia. Very easy.
All right. I think it's Music Man.
Are you on Twitter or Booger?
I should start Booger.
Booger.
The competition to Twitter. All right.